Hey, what's going on? I'm back. Thanks for 5 resubs, Marty. I'm tier one drunk in the resub certified Bugs Neo in the gift sub Mont Lamar. That was fun. What, is he still on? I thought he went off. No, yeah, he's already changed topics. The Prime, nope. I said I'd drop it. He got very upset, clearly. I thought we were just gonna have some fun, but I guess not. Didn't even respond to the DM after looking at it, so yeah, he's mad mad. I'm sorry. Should have taken his feelings into account. That's on me. It's real boy and sufficient. And the 5 resubs, JJ. Thanks, JJ. So yeah, anyway, Logan Paul, what a goofball, am I right, guys? He's a prime Mickey. And the prime Jubilee. The resub skeleton and Armstrong. Yeah, it's gonna be a pretty dog shit investigation Logan Paul does, if that's the angle he's going for, which it seems like it is. Any new police chases? Nah, just this one from the other day. It wasn't too good. Was mediocre. Man, you goddamn cucks keep coming back every time it seems like it dies down for a second, so you can, like, when Sneeko ducks for a little while, then you come in, stir the pot again. But he won't even watch the clips. You guys won't even watch the clips. Watch the clips, then get back to me. Thanks to the resub Mookie and the Prime Husky. It's so petty. It is, but it was fun. It's always enjoyable to dabble in the pig pen for a bit. I just wish it was more reciprocated. He didn't even bother to really play ball. He avoided any of the things that would really hurt his feelings. Thanks to the bits, Banana and Marty. And maybe Marty, we'll see. Seems sad knowing Logan seemed to have matured from everything but then shot himself in the foot. Yeah, his PR for a while was really cooking. Wait, where'd that tweet just go? Oh, there it is. They did a great job of reinventing himself post dead body and all that shit. But this could, hey, maybe he's gonna shock everyone with the craziest investigation and the wildest receipts where he was a victim. Logan Paul turns out to have been scammed by everyone else. What a fucking wild twist that would be. Yourself literally said he changed like last year. Yeah, I mean, I really believed it. He signed with the WWE, and I watched one of his wrestling matches. I mean, he seemed good at it. I don't really watch wrestling, but I mean, he seemed to know what he was doing. People seemed to have really liked him in the community there. CoffeeZilla replied to that tweet. Yeah, it was a good reply too. About Save the Kids token. Did you borrow that green screen from somewhere? Wait, where'd the reply go? There it is. Sneeko said he lapped you on Twitch. That's fine. He's got great viewership on Rumble, and congratulations to him. I just wish he wasn't such a bitch. Watch the clips. Give your audience something to really enjoy instead of you repeating the same goddamn NPC response over and over. Watch the goddamn clips. Things are a bit steep water. Hey, Suzel. It's easier to just do the same thing like Marvel does. Yeah, I guess. He's kind of like the Marvel of alpha males. Though he'd never consider himself an alpha male, to be fair. Thanks, Reese of Allied. Why don't you play them? Are they banned? Oh, they're just my clips. It was just a series of insults I tossed his way. He just ducks anything that he knows will hurt his feelings. They're not like exposed clips or anything. It's just me childishly insulting him. But I thought there were some zingers in there. But he won't watch them because he knows it's going to make him feel bad. Thanks to the Prime Duddy. Yeah, I made a whole thing on the Tate arrest. I saw. I mean, it'd be impossible not to see. Thanks to the recent Quickscope and the Prime Kid. And the bits grapes. Am I gonna play Div Oh, yeah. For Warframe? Absolutely. I'm still just trying to max in RuneScape, and then I've been grinding WoW because I want to finish the raid. But yeah, I absolutely will be going back to Warframe. 100%. That game's great. How Speedrunners Broke Family Guy. I thought I had watched that, but it's apparently brand new, so yeah, I haven't seen that yet. Think the Prime Thanatos. I have literally sent Sneeko a DM. He has not responded. That's on him, not me, man. He is the one that is not responding. Don't let him fucking fool you. I have sent him a DM, which he has opened. And not responded to, pretending he doesn't know what a fucking DM is. Stop. He's posturing. Jesus Christ. Why is he still on this? It's clearly hurting him to a very deep degree. Why won't he just drop it and move on to something that his audience is just gonna eat up? He's a tier one moose and give sub Marty. Talking about DMs when he was talking to you live, you disingenuous snake. I was talking to him live and he won't listen. What do you mean? Ask him to watch my clips. I was talking directly to him and he won't listen. What are you talking about? You guys are so fucking brainwashed. What do you mean? I have done everything. I have DM'd him. I have tried my best to communicate with him, and he ducks it because it hurts his feelings, and he doesn't want to look weak. I get it, but he should just move on in that case. He's the one that started this, by the way. I was down to just talk about Logan Paul being a goofball. What are you fucking talking about? He will not watch anything that I have said. Good Lord. Makes me some diarrhea and red and skinny. He's the prime SEMO. He's the prime Muda. No, that was pretty much it from Logan. I was just saying that was like the main thing on my docket. And then the AMOC speed runs are getting real close to being fucking fierce. We've got a ton of sub 30s now. Those were the two big things. Still no huge discoveries though. He's the resub Graffiti and the prime Ainz Al Ghul. The Bits J. The creator of Sonic got arrested over insider trading. Yeah, oh yeah, I know. That was a while back. Fights and brawls are breaking out at Disney. And yeah, that sounds about right, Jay. Oh, he got arrested again. Thanks, Reese Payton. That's just Florida, home of Disney World. Yeah. I mean, shit breaks out at Disney all the time. Still, one of the best brawls to ever be recorded happened at Disney. This had everything. I had an old man come in on like a scooter, or it was an old woman who came in on like a scooter and hit somebody in the fray. It was wild. The Disney brawls go so hard. Oh, but I guess this has been such a phenomenon, they had to issue a warning. Disney is not a Waffle House, take your fights elsewhere, I guess. You know, it happens all the time. You gonna stream hitting 99 Slayer? Yeah, I will. I'm only at 95 right now, though. Thanks to Prime Zaid and the resub Rin and Hypno. I did see the newest Waffle House fight. I was talking about that yesterday, where that lady had the craziest parry on that chair. Jesus. It's this one.
Yo, man. Ah, bro. You wildin'. Yo, chill. You going to
Oh, I missed
die,
it.
bro.
She hits an actual frame
Oh,
perfect parry on this. Yeah, no, it's an actual parry in real life. Straight out of Dark Souls. But aside from that, the brawl itself was pretty uneventful. It was mainly just grabbing each other. But yeah, it was a perfect parry. Literal Avenger, true. Thanks to Risa, Bexter, and Bunny. Logan Paul just replied again. What, just now? No. Why do you tell me lies? What was the point of Oh, it was a. Oh. You mean a reply to someone? Well, how does that? God, that's lame. Holy shit, that's so fucking lame. I hope this is just a stock image and he didn't just break a coffee mug for the sake of this stupid picture. Holy Lord, that's so lame. Retweets. Yeah, this one's doing numbers. Thanks to the Prime Godly. What do you think the most impressive 99 in old school RuneScape is? Agility. Getting the 99 agility without throwing yourself down a set of stairs is an achievement. Thanks to the bits, Tichon. Probably just gonna make an ass of himself come the third. Again, it's gonna boil down to him just blaming everyone else. Jake the Crypto King manipulated all of us. We wanted to make the best game ever, but Jake wouldn't let it happen. And then Eddie lied to everyone. Eddie Ibanez was a real villain. He was the puppet master. I was just the face of it and had no idea that it was actually not a real game. It is just a stock image. Well, that's good at least. Thanks, Risa Blart. Have you gone down the Chuck E. Cheese brawl rabbit hole? That's not really a rabbit hole. There's like the occasional fight. Chuck E. Cheese, but it's not often. It's not like Disney, it's not like Waffle House. Chuck E. Cheese is just the occasional parents throw in hands. It's not like a really big one. One thing you didn't take into account is him saying it was a clone to promote it. Yeah, anything's possible with Logan Paul, man. One thing I don't think we're going to see is accountability from him. I don't think there's a shot. How the fuck did Logan Paul go from Viner to Disney to scammer? Vine used to be huge, man, and he got big off of doing splits. Oh, and then his strawberry thing, whatever the fuck that was. But yeah, that was huge. Vine for its time was massive. Gonna play anything? Yeah, I think I'm probably gonna do some more speed runs tonight. Thanks to Prime Rudy. Are there fights at SeaWorld? No, not that I know of. Usually it's just the employees fighting the animals. There's no like human on human fights. Thanks to the bits, Amdom. What's going on with Logan? It's his crypto Zeus scam. Oh, sweet. Well, thanks, Sensei. Hope you had a good holiday. Thanks to Resub RJ. Did Khaled recently post something about going to a theme park for the first time? Thanks to Prime Jackie. Oh my god. I'm assuming viewership went down on Sneeko's stream. Is that why he's coming back again? Ugh. That's a tell. Yep, he lost 4K viewers, so he's trying to stir it again. Still hasn't replied to my DM, man. I don't know how I'm supposed to communicate with him. He won't listen to me on stream. He won't reply to my DM. I don't know what the fuck you want from me. This is clearly just a ploy for attention. His views drop. He comes in here, tries to start shit, and that's it. Now it's just getting sad. I thought this was going to be fun. It was for a little while. Now it's just getting sad. He's a tier 1 sensei. And the resub nuclear. Yeah, actually, Waffle House went to a code red recently for, what was it, Hurricane Ivan? Yeah, code reds for Waffle House do happen. It's just not common. Don't know any. What? Oh, I didn't see that. People still being found buried under buffalo snow. That sucks. Oh, Hurricane Ian. That's what it was. Yeah. Hurricane Ian. There's a code red for that. Already wait. Oh no, I didn't see that, Bob. Andrew Tate released on bail. Did that just happen? That's huge. Well, I don't see anything about that. Even as of 42 minutes ago, still detained, being investigated by Romanian police. Where do you see that? Yeah, I didn't see that anywhere. At least not in these headlines. Thanks to the Bits MCO. It was loads of fake tweets saying it. I mean, they might not be fake. Like, maybe this is just really new, so it's not in any headlines. Like, it sounds super plausible. I mean, fucking SBF got released on bail, 250 mil bail. So, I mean, I don't doubt that it could happen for Tate. The video was fake. Entirely possible as well. Watch Sneeko now. Yeah, I heard he got a gun out or something, talking shit. I mean, okay. All right. Look, again, I have messaged him. I have done everything I can. It doesn't seem like he wants to actually communicate. So please, stop. Jesus. I have done everything to try and communicate here. He is the one that is not. That is not me. I will say it is a little sad to see him with a gun out now. He's like mad. I think that's pretty sad that he talks shit, I talk shit back, and he gets super offended and hurt, and now he just starts dancing with a gun. That's kind of pathetic. That's a bit of a tell. That's Thanks to the bits. It's Eliza. The prime Eric. Hey, happy birthday, Johnny. Thanks to Resub Bortimer. Thanks a bit, Cat. You're probably right, I know. Thanks a bit, Chorito. Resub don't know. In the Prime ZST. What's the most hours you've had in a game? Oh, RuneScape. And it's not even close. On just my current character, I have like fucking, what, 3,300 hours or something on him? Not even close. By far, RuneScape. That's just my current character. Thanks to Resub Blazers. Thanks to the resub Vizlo. He's saying he's going to shoot you. Uh-oh. Surely is a joke. Or does he mean in a game? That's a bold thing to just be saying online, publicly. But yeah, it looks like you're right. Isn't that a crime? Yep. It is. I'll give him the benefit of the doubt that he's just putting on a show for the chat. Yeah, I've already saved the whole stream just in case. I'm pretty sure people in chat have too. We'll see. I mean, we'll see, I guess. Hoping it's just supposed to be a little like joke or show for him. Couldn't tell you because I don't have it unmuted here. Red and Chloe. Thanks to Gifts of Joseph. He's saying it's fake now. Jesus. All right. Thanks to Gifts of Brandon and Air. The Bits Freak. In a sodium. Isn't this against Rumble Terms of Service? I didn't even know there was Rumble Terms of Service, so probably not. Thanks to give sub Keo. aggressive, taste too strong. Hot, hot, careful when you pour. Why don't we have these anymore? We do. I'll show you one in a sec. I just want the chorus to hit. And it'll be stuck in my head all night. Pop a top on a gasoline every time when these coffee tastes so fine. Hot drinks really get you going. Warm you up when you feel you're slowing. Wendy's, we always serve it right away. We'll smile and have a nice day. Actually, so hard. That shreds. Well, thanks for the tier 2, Tyra. Thanks for that. But yeah, we still have this. Like, this Utah senator made a music video. I think. It was a senator, right? Yeah. Yeah. Get a load of this. We still have these.
This candidate in Utah.
Show me the original. All right, what's her name? Karen Main. Nope. That's not it. Oh, Linda Paulson. Jesus. See? Mm. Bust it.
Hey, Utah District 12, listen up right here. There's a new name on the ballot for the Senate this year.
Thanks,
my
Risa
name
Twan.
Is Linda Paulson, Republican and awesome. Love God and,
the, bits, Bob and
the Constitution. I tried to get another conservative to run. Nobody could do it, so I'm getting it done. I'm pro-religious freedom, pro-life, pro-police. The right to bear arms.
That's not fast food. It's not fast food, but it's the most recent example I could think of.
Control and regulation want to stop and expose all political corruption. Where's integrity, morality, accountability, government programs
lead
to self-sufficiency, and support traditional family as the fundamental unit of society.
No, she didn't win.
But in schools, they're pushing
shockingly
for new beliefs. And just to clarify, that's a female adult. I know what a woman is.
She apparently she got like 40% though. Like she didn't get blown out.
This country, it's a blessing to be free, but freedom comes with responsibility. The Constitution needs to be protected, not changed or disregarded.
Thanks,
but
Resub Deepak.
Resurrected. If you share my values, if you like what I stand for, then give me your vote on the 8th of November.
Where's
this
the auto tuning? She made it herself
Let
in GarageBand.
You
don't know what the fuck auto tuning is.
Linda Paulson for Senate.
But yeah, you give her another 6 months, she's coming out with sicko mode. I'm telling you right now, Linda Paulson's got bars. You just give her some time in what is it, Fruity Loops? No, they changed the name. What the fuck is it called now? FL, no, is it FL Studio still? I don't remember. But yeah, you give her some time in there. Maybe work on the flow a little bit. She's gonna come out with fire. I'm telling you. Oh, it is FL Studio? She takes, well, Linda Paulson's coming back. Gonna release another wild track. Too bad she wasn't pro acting class. Hey man, it has nothing to do with acting. What are you talking about? I think the acting was fire. The only criticism I would have for Linda Paulson is maybe work on, you know, the lyrics, the beat, the flow. Also the attire. She could have dressed into something much cooler. Maybe like a G-string. I'm just spitballing though. Thanks to the bits, Camus. Oh yeah, I saw Sunny V2 uploaded a new banger. The East Hills Shopping Center rap? Which one's that? I don't recognize this one.
It's him for back to school. Denim haircut. Backpacks, backpacks, come get your backpack.
Boots and pants and boots and pants.
This is pretty good. I feel like I could hear this on SiriusXM right now.
Denim.
Boots and pants and boots and pants.
Haircut. New shoes. So get yourself back to school with these tails.
Wow.
Haircut.
What? Why are they so fixated on the haircuts? Jesus Christ. Cool. Do you remember the coffee toffee? Twisted Frosty Wendy's commercial? Coffee toffee. Twisted Frosty. What? Is it a song? Song? Oh, I don't know this one.
Yo, it's time for a coffee break.
Not quite.
Let's do this, homies.
When I need a tasty treat to pick me up, that lifts me off my feet.
God damn, Linda Paulson's got competition. Jesus. This is cool. This is good. I never saw this one. Is this BTS? Better than BTS.
It's way better than fast food. It's Wendy's.
Wendy's just has an absolute stranglehold on catchy tunes. Because they also have cold drinks, by the way. It's just not as good as hot drinks. They actually have a tune for everything. But this one's too, like, uppity. Like, I don't like this one because it doesn't groove as hard. But it's still not bad. I don't know what Wendy's was doing in the 90s. They were killing it.
Are you ready? Here we go. Soft drinks, lemonade, water, cold tea. It's up to you. It's up to me.
Cold drinks come in. Four cups, got another side before you fill it up.
Biggie, medium, small, kid's meal. Keep it straight. It's a good deal. Use the scoop to fill with ice. Never use the cup. Take my advice. For soft drinks, fill the ice halfway. No matter
the size, that's what I say. It's more like a diss track, almost.
Push against the lever. Keeps the foam down now. Isn't that clever? If there's still foam, let it settle down. Don't pour it off, or your boss will frown. When you reach a quarter inch from the top, that's where you want to stop. If the customers say they want to stay, put the drink on the left hand side of the tray. If the order's to go, put the lid on tight. Make sure it pops to do it right. Then hand that drink to the coordinator and tell the guest you'll see him later.
Education connection. Yeah, that was a big one.
Don't forget to smile when you serve cold drinks.
This one slaps. It's just not as good as hot drinks. Or coffee toffee twisted frosty, I guess.
You're the one that can make the difference.
For lemonade, things stay the same.
Like, the song just reminds me of something from the first Men in Black. Where they have that, the alien dance number at the end. The food quality, if only their food quality matched their song quality. Their food's fine. It's not like the best, but it's fine. Thanks, Risa Brian. I've never had like a bad Wendy's meal. Thanks, Prime Pixel. Imagine actually having to listen to an album for training. These weren't training videos, though, I don't think, were they? Like, they're geared, like, they're made like training videos, but I'm pretty sure these were just released online. I could be misremembering, though. Maybe they really did show him. They were originally training videos. I thought it was just part of like if Wendy's campaign online from back in the day. He's a tier one Android and three sub Roscoe. Because for a while, advertising for, I guess not really just fast food, but fast food had a lot of old ads they'd run online, which were really like goofy and really like trying to be trendy. So they'd have songs and shit. Is Risa Breezy? There's no internet in 1989. What do you see in 1989? I'm pretty sure this was late 90s and this was early 2000s. Let me see. I'll double check. Oh! 1989. Interesting. Yep, no, that was just actually a training video. Your sense of time is bad. Yeah, you're not wrong. Thanks, Risa Breezy. Looks too old to be 2000s. I think you're misremembering what 2000s used to look like. Because Yo-Yo Ball absolutely still looked like that. And I used to watch this all the time. Okay, not in Russian. Or whatever that was. Oh, Portuguese, I guess. But like, all, for a while, everything looked the same. So yeah, 89 absolutely looked like 2000. 100%. Why not just get a yo-yo? I don't know, man. I'm not their dad. What the fuck you want from me? I have no idea why they didn't just get a yo-yo. Did you watch the Jujutsu Kaisen movie? I did. I just didn't moist meter it at the time. It was good. It was a little underwhelming because I was expecting like something Demon Slayer level, but it wasn't quite there. But it was still good. I just wish they didn't skip things like Toto fighting. That was really upsetting. But it wasn't bad. Purple ketchup. I used to love purple ketchup, man. That shit was so good. And they had the Jimmy Neutron ketchup as well. That easy squirt. Thanks, Risa Gavin. That purple ketchup shit sucks ass. Man, what the fuck are you talking about? It's just normal ketchup, but they put food coloring in it. It is literally just normal ketchup. Sorry to spoil Christmas. Woo! Is it Risa Nacho? No, I don't know the one at all, Nacho. Have you seen the old Quiznos commercial with the singing rat? Yes. Books are just acoustic Kindles. Man, what in the bath salts are you talking about? What? Makes it get so icy. And the resub SV. Check out Frankie Flight Hoot Wireless. I think I'll pass. I don't know what that is. That sounds fucking awful though. That seems real wacky. No more commercials. I think I'm all commercialed out. Like resub yellow. The Noid. That's such a sad story though, man. Yeah, the Noid even had his own video game and everything. But man, I'm sure you guys all know the story of the Noid, right? This ended up with a hostage situation. So there was a guy with a mental illness whose last name, I think his name was Kevin Noid, something like that. And he used to think that these advertisements were directly threatening him. So one day he held up a Domino's at gunpoint. It's fucked up. Easy tier 1 Ash. That's why they retired the Noid. But I guess they brought him back. Looks like it at least. Is there a video on it? Oh, absolutely. I'm sure there's tons. Here, let me see what his name was. I'm pretty sure it was Kevin Noid. Avoid the Noid is what the slogan was, I believe. Yep. Domino's Pizza, avoid the Noid. And it led to the Chamblee hostage incident of 1989 when Kenneth Noid believed that Avoid the Noid was personally directed towards him and was antagonizing him. So he entered a Domino's in Georgia armed with a Magnum, and Noid held two employees hostage for over 5 hours. What was he demanding? What were his demands? They were pretty weird. After offering to exchange a hostage for a copy of American postmodern author Robert Anton Wilson's 1985 novel, The Widow's Son, Noid released one of his... Wait, what? Oh, I see. I misunderstood. So he made the offer that he would release someone for that book, but then didn't. Noid then became hungry and forced the captive employees to make him two pizzas. And when Noid ate the pizzas with his gun on his lap, the hostages escaped, and then he surrendered to the police shortly thereafter. Two shots were fired by Noid during the incident. And it's got a really sad conclusion. Charged with kidnapping, assault, extortion, possession of a firearm during a crime, and was found not guilty by reason of insanity, Noid subsequently spent time in a mental institution and died by suicide in 1995. Yeah, it's just a terrible thing all around, really. Is he resub Smelly and Adrenalite? That's why the Noid stopped being part of their marketing for so long. Domino's really fucked that guy over. I mean, it's not their fault. Like, how are they supposed to know? That's just remarkably unlucky. I think they resub Liam and the Prime Muffins. It's like the guy who thought he had won a jet or something. Well, that wasn't a mental illness. That was a guy that gamed the system and thought he won a Harrier jet. I was just being a little silly. Though they should have at least paid him what that thing was worth with all the effort he went through getting that fucking Harrier jet. Points for it. Imagine the time I watched the video about a woman who killed her daughter because SpongeBob told her to do it. Yeah, these aren't exactly goofy topics, but yeah, that one wasn't even that long ago. Lady killed her daughter, or was it her daughter? I thought it was, maybe it was her daughter, because she thought SpongeBob was telling her to do that. Yeah, definitely not a goofy topic. Shit was wacky in the worst way. You seen Bill Cosby going on tour next year? Yeah, chat told me last night. I'm getting tickets. I have to know what a Bill Cosby tour is gonna look like. You think he'll sell drinks? Don't be ridiculous. Drinks will be free. Thanks, your resub toaster. You won't remember it? Hey, I've got it up right now. I've had this up for the last 24 hours. I am not missing when he drops the ticket sales for the Bill Cosby World Tour 2023. You bet your ass I'm gonna go see Bill Cosby. That's gotta be like the biggest absolute fucking disaster of a tour. Oh, you won't remember after. Oh, I thought you meant I won't remember to get tickets. I see what you're saying now. Because of what he did. Now I get you. Now it's connecting. How the fuck did he even get off? You talking about how did he get out of jail? I don't remember all the particulars now. It was something about he confessed or something, but under not the best circumstances? Ah, fuck, I don't remember. It was some weird shit. It was a weird ruling. These are the bits, potato. No, it wasn't a plea deal or anything. It was something about I think the prosecutors did something wrong. Like they didn't play entirely by the rules, which gave them wiggle room to get Cosby out. I just can't remember what the fuck it was, like what exactly happened. Oh, that might be it. That might have been it. They said they wouldn't use the evidence, meaning like when he confessed in the trial, but they did. I think that's what it was. That sounds right. I think that's what it was. Thanks, a resub stabby in the bits, Jay. Prosecutors violated Mr. Cosby's rights by going back on an apparent promise not to charge him. The court majority ruled on October 14th, 2021. Okay, so then yeah, that's what it was. Thanks to the resub dark and the bits wacky. Thanks to the resub goose. What's going on with the Ron Jeremy case? I have no clue. I haven't kept up with that at all. That sounds right, Jay. Why don't you say that? Because I don't know how to fucking say it, all right? I don't want to sound stupid. I know what the word means, I just don't know how to say the word, and I don't want to sound dumb. And you guys will make fun of me for being a goddamn buffoon. So I don't want to say it wrong. I'm gonna give sub Nikki and resub Comfy. And the resub Uriel. Rap TV has updates on Andrew Tate and his brother being released, saying that he was released. Is that right? So is that confirmed? Like I said, that wouldn't be surprising. Like getting out on bail or something. Romanian officials have confirmed that Andrew Tate... Oh, from Rap TV. Breaking. Romanian officials have confirmed that Andrew Tate wasn't arrested on human trafficking charges. However, he is being questioned for money laundering. And his brother Tristan is reportedly already released. Interesting. Is anyone else reporting that? Or is that just... I don't know, Rap TV. Is that a good source? Didn't the broadcast literally have trafficking in it? Let me see. No, this is not a good source. Rap TV is not reliable at all. Okay, overwhelmingly knows. All right, I'll wait. I'll wait for other sources then, I guess. I don't know anything about Rap TV. That's the first time I've seen them. But that would be quite the twist. Liver King is being sued for $25 million. Is it for misleading and false advertising or something? That'd be my guess. Liver King sued for $25 million by customers tricked by his steroid, or who were tricked into buying his muscle building supplements when in fact he was taking steroids. Yeah, he really opened himself up to this one, huh? I still think that's a hard thing to win, though. $25 million, sheesh. I mean, that's a fat load. Is it a class action? Sounds like a class action. But I mean, yeah, that was a lawsuit waiting to happen. Is it really hard to win? It was false advertising. It was blatantly false advertising and lying in order to sell product. But I still think winning a case like this is tough, isn't it? Because otherwise you could go after so many other targets. Thanks for your sub, Winklebottom. Yeah, probably. Not wrong, Winklebottom. Don't most athletes do the same thing? Well, the difference is athletes, A, don't admit, like, yep, I'm taking a bunch of steroids. After selling something else. So like, you want to get jacked, get this goat urine. But then it turns out he didn't get jacked with goat urine. He got jacked with steroids and HGH and shit. Like, it's a little different. But yeah, 25 mil, that's a fat load of doubloons here. And according to this, it says 40 mil AUD. There. But yeah, it seems to be real. It seems like they're going for it. Letting it rip. Assuming all of his claims are accurate, the guy makes 100 mil a year, so... Makes sense that they're shooting for the moon. aren't people going to cheat for the 10K, Splice, etc.? Nope. We have a team verifying the runs are legitimate. Plus, almost every single one of them is streamed. Thanks to the Bits Adrenal Elite. Search Pickle Surprise. What is that, porn or something? Oh, it's this thing. Yeah, I've seen this. Yeah, I remember that. He's a tier 1 swag boy. Goes to the other screen. Yeah, anytime that I think it's going to be porn that's recommended, I just do it up here. One time someone recommended a girl spreading her entire ass with one of those giant dildos just to prove that someone could fuck the Moby Huge, even though it wasn't a Moby Huge. Yeah, I just do it just to be safe. No reason to take the chance. Cis wet white, right? Yeah. I think that's who it was. Pretty sure. They're the only one that's that courageous. Didn't even know the human asshole was capable of spreading like that. Just like a genetic gift, I guess. There's Prime Justin and Tier 1 Swag Boy. And the Resub Possum and 5 Gift Sub Swag. Thank you for that, man. Appreciate the generosity. She could definitely do the Moby Huge. No, she... There is not a single human being on the planet that could actually put the Moby Huge inside their ass or pussy. It's impossible. Maybe the tip. I've always said maybe the tip, but never like the actual shaft. Like the full shaft or anything close to it. It would legitimately be... You would die. Oh, thank you for the 10 gift subs, Keo. Thank you again for the generosity. Put a bounty? That'd just be literally putting a bounty on suicide. If you actually tried to put the Moby Huge inside of you, you would die. It would tear your whole colon. And let's say, God forbid, gravity is working against you, like you lose your footing and you fall on it. You're just going to like actually impale yourself internally. It would rupture every organ in your body. It is a 3-foot, 62-pound dildo. And it's super girthy. We shot that motherfucker with a shotgun and it didn't even go through. Oh, thank you for the 50 gift subs, Dark. Jesus Christ. God damn, thank you for that. Thanks for the huge drop. Hope you had a great holiday, man. Thanks for you said Volton Insane. God damn. Thank you, Dark. Resub Dust Bunny. So it's a souvenir. Yeah, it's a joke item. It's just a silly little goofy giant penis. It's not something anyone could actually use. It would kill you. It's a sculpture. Yeah, I guess it's more like a sculpture. Sculpture, like a piece of art. Next to Resub Girthquake. The Prime Arduini. Baby head has to be bigger. Jesus Christ! No, a baby head is not bigger. No, it's not even close. God damn it. I don't know why you're arguing with me. I own 5 of them. I assure you, there is no human body that can handle the Moby Huge. Is there Resub Golfing? Resub Tortellini in the Prime. Already said that. And then the resub dust bunny. Why is someone comparing it to a baby's head? Oh, the angle they were working with was like giving birth. I think. I don't know. I'm giving them the benefit of the doubt. I think that's what they were going for. Thanks to resub tests and tier 1 saints. Andre the Giant?
Nah,
doubt it. What pushed you past buying more than three? Did a competition. Whoever could hold the Moby Huge the longest without setting it down won 10 grand. I was shocked by our athlete's determination. It's 62 pounds, and it's extremely hard to hold. They went for hours. There's the resub Stone Samurai. And the resub Kev. How much do they cost? What, the Moby Huge? It's like $600. They're expensive. I mean, that's 3 feet of wiener. Like, they're going to charge a premium. They also ship it in the worst way imaginable. Every time I've ordered a Moby Huge, it gets here and looks like it's actually just been beat up by, like, a professional athlete. The box has holes in it. Half of it's fucking ripped off. It's like someone was just ravenous to, like, touch the Moby Huge. It shows up in the worst condition imaginable. Is it tier 1 serotonin? Because it's 60 pounds? There's plenty of things you order that are like 60 pounds. But for some reason, when it comes to the Moby Huge, it shows up and looks like it's been attacked by a pack of wolves. Doesn't make any sense. There's also no packaging to it. It's just a box and then the penis. I don't remember them ever putting like plastic around it or foam or anything. So I guess what must happen is in transit, it just starts beating the shit out of everyone else's package. People probably get real mad when I order a Moby Huge because it ruins all of their packages around it by proxy. Is the Prime Panini Zoro Bryce and the resub Sindante? Give sub sniper. The Prime Joan. Did you ever use the Moby Huge? Not like in my ass or anything. I've used it for so much shit though. Made an entire car out of it. Yeah, every Moby Huge gets put to good use. Every one of them. Thanks for resub Nightfall. Show us. I can't, it's Twitch. Made a video on it like last year. My dad turned it into a little go-kart. What did I call that video? I think it's like Tesla's newest model or something. The fuck did I call that? Anyone remember? I don't remember what I called that one. Is the Prime Beastly and the Prime Roball? Next generation Tesla, that's what I called it. We still have it. It doesn't really run anymore. All the tires are flat, so we'll have to get a new set of tires on that puppy. But yeah, the little penis mobile could go like 15. Yeah, I already watched the new police chase. As we said, PP and drunk. Oh, that sucks. I'm sorry to hear that, Jay. Yeah, so I saw the Rap TV post about Andrew Tate being taken in on money laundering. But right now, that's still the only source. I have it pulled up, and I just refreshed it. There's still nothing else reporting that it's money laundering, but we'll see. I'm super curious now. That'd be big. Money laundering makes much more sense than human trafficking. Yeah, money laundering sounds a lot more standard of a crime. But he was also really open about what he used to do, or I maybe even still does, I don't quite recall, where he used to like fly women in to be cam models for him. Do you guys not remember that? That was like one of his first hustles. He'd like promise to date women, but then actually force them to be cam models. And he'd take like all of their profit. So it's not unrealistic to think that there was a human trafficking element to that. What evidence is there? Well, they haven't released it publicly. He just said that once. He was talking about one of his first hustles being taking the cam girl's money. He said that like a long time ago. That's not like a secret. He admitted to it. It's not even admitting to it. He literally just talks about it. It's not like it was a secret he was keeping. It's not like it was a one-time thing. He just talks about it being like his first hustle for money, about making the women do camming. That is admitting to it. Well, yeah, but admitting to it makes it sound like it was a secret that he just like slipped out. It's not. He literally talks about it openly. Or at least used to. I don't know if he still does. He's a tier 1 otter in the Prime Strack and resub Nate and Random. And yeah, I did see that, Samboni. There's evidence on DJ Academics Insta about Andrew Tate. Evidence about what? Him being released or why he got arrested? I don't really follow DJ Academics, man. I'll take a peek though. Fuck it, I'm not doing anything right now. What's his Instagram again? It's not just DJ Academics, is it? Oh, it is. Man, what the fuck is this? It is literally just him promoting his upcoming show. What are you talking about? Did you tell me to go on here just to see his upcoming show or something? You like his marketing manager or something? His 2023 New Year's blowout? I'll just wait for other sources to report on it. We'll see. But yeah, it seems like there's a lot floating around, a lot of different stories floating around. We'll see what's actually going on pretty soon, I'm sure. It's on his page, he just posts a lot. I can't believe I'm going back. You're lucky you caught me at a time where there's not a whole lot of topics happening right now. This is once again his Merry Christmas card from 5 days ago. What do you mean? Am I on the wrong page? Like, he's a 5 gift subs proxy. Appreciate it. What's the right page then if it's not DJ Academics? Thanks to 5 gift subs, Keo. He has 35,000 posts. Holy shit. It's just at Academics. Well, that didn't come up at all. Are you sure? Oh, here it is. Here it is. Found it. His last post was December 20th. Oh, Jesus. How many pages does he have? Wait, there's another one. Is this the one? This is from July. There's like 1,000 fucking pages, all of which posted in the bio of each Academics page I go to. What is the correct one? It's just Academics. I searched that and nothing comes up. I cannot find just an at Academics. I think it's shadow banned. Well, it must be because I can't find it. I found like 5 other Academics pages, but not that one. Here, I can find it by going through Google, not through Instagram. Okay, now I'm on the right one. Holy shit. How did that take so many pages going through? What are those, fan pages? There was like 1,000. Yeah, no, I had to Google it because he doesn't come up on Instagram. Jesus. Okay. You said he posted evidence about Tate's arrest? Oh, this is about the money laundering thing that Rap TV reported about. Unconfirmed, but source close to this is Twitter user Nick Sortor. I'm not sure who that is. Told us the arrest is in relation to money laundering, not rape. The charge was human trafficking, not rape. Well, I mean, maybe that's probably part of it with human trafficking, but that wasn't like the charge. Tate will be purposely held for an extended amount of time. It's still an ongoing investigation. The terrorism is in regards to conversations about the Taliban, which were posted online, including some videos. That's why counterterrorism got involved. I'm unfamiliar with Nick Sorter, but maybe. We'll see. Yeah, I'm super interested to see what the full story is. Because I'm pretty sure the arrest video, when translated, actually had like trafficking in the title. But yeah, so we'll see. Thanks for giving subs, swag boy. This arrest is just a trailer for 2023. Yeah, maybe. Is there some smoking in tree? Can someone tell me what he's looking at? You! I'm always reading the chat. Have you seen DJ Academics falls asleep listening to Drake? I actually pulled that up on stream. That had me giggling. That was Drake's Damien Hirst album, right? Yeah, he was doing like a listen along and just fucking fell asleep. That was great. That was actually a classic. Here, I'll pull that up again. I love that one.
smoking on top fives? Where is he at? What top five you smoking on, Kendrick?
He said he seemed so hyped going into it, too.
Drake. You ain't doing a shit, nigga.
And then he actually plays it and falls asleep.
For no fucking reason.
Does this have the whole thing? I skipped it.
His daddy, that's a fact.
Oh, they don't show the whole thing. So good. That is just such a good clip. Thanks to some Baba Yaga and Scott Steiner. I don't even really dislike Drake's music, man. He's got a lot of stinkers, but he has some good songs too. Like most artists. I just don't really like Drake himself. But yeah, I don't like hate his music or anything, man. You got the wrong idea. But he has some stinkers, like some smelly ones. There's a Resub Germ, Kaido, and Llama. All right, I'm going to take a piss real quick. Give me 2 seconds. I'll be right back. Oh, I'm back. Thanks, Erisa. Nostalgia. Or 90s nostalgia. Tier 1 gang. Erisa Bibbler and Gift Sub Radiator. No, I just always wash my hands thoroughly when I wash them. Thanks, Erisa Draws. The resub shack. The resub Mizuvi. Do you like what Nikocado and Upaville have been doing? Yeah, I haven't listened to their podcast yet, but it seems like they're having fun. Thanks to the Prime Mark. The Risa Broski. What do I listen to for music? As basic bitch of an answer as it is, a little bit of everything except country, but my main genre is metal. Recently, I've been listening to a lot of like smaller artists. One in particular. I don't know how many of you listen to this guy. He's not super huge yet, but he's super good. His name's Do Not Resurrect. His shit goes so hard. So I've been listening to a lot of Do Not Resurrect recently. Have you heard of Periphery? Yeah, of course I have. Will Godslap have an online release? It already does. There's a digital copy. Godslapbook.com. Oh shit, this guy made 2077. Love that song. Oh, so good. Yeah. Deftones fan. It's my favorite band. Used to be really into If I Were You, right? I still like If I Were You. Oh, now we're just going through music here. Yep. I'm a fan, Rotok. Thanks to Recent Puffer. Have you heard of a game called Judgment? Mm-hmm. Jackson loves that game. Next, the Prime. DRP. Does he do music for Love, Death, and Robots? What? Who? Is he resub Nate? And there he said Tony and Smog. Oh, you're talking about Do Not Resurrect? No. You remember Glow Porches? Yeah, that was when we were just listening to some wild shit. This was back during RuneScape streams. I wanted chat to recommend any song that was like cuck adjacent, but this song's not even close to being like about being cucked. It's just like an actual good song. This was a long time ago. This song still goes hard. It's like something you'd hear out of like Napoleon Dynamite. It's like a feel-good kind of song. Is the resub Huck in the Berry? Music to hit 99 agility too. Yeah. Like, I don't usually listen to anything that even comes close to this, but I like this song. It's just so, like, feel-goody. In, like, a sad way, kinda. There's, like, 5,000 bands that sound like this. Oh, I don't doubt it. Stream RuneScape again? Yeah, when I get 99 Slayer. You listen to rap much? Yep. Take it back. I won't. plan for tonight. I'll probably start speedrunning in a minute. Well, I don't know, it's getting kind of late. Maybe I'll just play some goofy shit. I'm just enjoying getting a little goofy here. Do you like or dislike Suicide Boys? I like Suicide Boys. They have like a weird community, not like in a bad way, but for some reason, every time I'm not logged in on YouTube, I always get recommended Naruto AMVs for the Suicide Boys. So like, this. This, for some reason, always pops up as a recommended video for me, and I don't get why. Every time. But yeah, I do like Suicide Boys, but man, they must have like all anime fans. It's so good, that's why. I mean, I watched it. It is good. It's also just a good song. The car community loves Suicide Boys. That's interesting. Seems like a lot of from the weeds. I've seen zero anime and I'm proud, I'm God. Hey, you're lost, man. Anime's fun. Unless you get really into it, then it gets kind of cringe, but yeah. But yeah, I get recommended that all the fucking time. YouTube really likes that one. It's good, though. Bring back the anime MILF era. Amen, brother, I guess. Is it Prime Ultric? Yeah, that sounds about right, Rotak. Sleep well, Snert. Thanks to the resub, Zini. You listen to much Polyphia?
Mm-hmm.
You excited for Zillikami's? Yeah, I am excited for his new album. I really like Zillikami. You ever listen to Japanese metal? Yeah, I do. Not Garugamesh. But yeah, Cold Rain and Crystal Lake are great. Garugamesh just became way too much of a meme. I don't even know if their music's good, but I can never listen to them because of this. From way back in the day, Sakata-Con 09. So I can never listen to them.
I love sushi.
I love Japan, period.
Mm-hmm. The tea ceremonies.
J-Rock!
Yeah.
Garugamesh! Oh,
yeah. Amen!
I love anime!
Yeah. And manga!
Oh, and gaming!
Yeah! DDR!
Oh, DDR, take me back.
Hey! Sakura Kan Ikima!
Don't just talk about it. Check out SakuraCon, April 10th through 12th. Check SakuraCon.org for all the details.
Still iconic. But yeah, I'll never listen to Garugamesh just because of that meme.
Garugamesh!
Ancient meme. Yep. Vintage. Favorite Norm MacDonald joke / bit? Oh, it's so hard to choose. I still really love the one about the classroom show and tell, not show and tell, the classroom stories about what their parents do, or like a lesson from their parents or something. I can't even remember the premise, but that it was about my dad works at the hatchery, this and that, and then he gets into Dirty Johnny. I still think that's one of his best jokes, the whole Dirty Johnny joke. God, rest in peace, Norm. So fucking good. Thanks, Risa Dami in the Prime Ballistic. You excited for new Chainsaw Man episodes? Brother, I got bad news. It's over. Season 1 just ended. Thanks to the gift so beastly. He's a tier 1 toe sucker. What do you recommend to a 21-year-old that wants to get into gaming? Bro, what do you mean? 21's like not old. Like any game ever. Like anything ever released ever. If you want to get into gaming. He's a resub Wolf. Peepo and give sub Addy. AMOC? Oh yeah, true. You could get into AMOC speedrunning if you want. We're knocking on the door of a sub 29. Sleep well, Mez. No, I didn't finish Andor yet. It's good, though. I just still haven't finished it. No rush. I have no doubt that they're good, Jay. It's just, like, out of principle, I can't because of this shit. Thanks, Reset Bomberman. I want to see a WWE match, CoffeeZilla entering the ring, no shirt, just his straps, and Logan Paul coming out of an egg. Man, just go watch porn. Jesus. Good lord. Goddamn, the horny posting. You ever listen to Slipknot or Korn? A little bit. I don't dislike them, but I don't actively listen either. Here's the resub salt can. Thanks, Resub Cambe. Dauntlet, I don't know what that is. Is that a game? Have you seen the YouTuber who's stuck in 2008? What's that mean? Like they're still making. Oh, it's these skits. I see, it's the skits. Okay, I know what you're talking about now. Yeah. I thought it was like a video essay on someone. Gotcha, I get it now. No, his name is Cooper? What? What is happening? Cooper 2723. What the fuck is happening? Oh, it's a channel. This? Seems like it's just a kid posting gameplay videos. Who is Cooper2723, the internet's strangest YouTuber? Single-handedly the fastest growing YouTuber on the platform without any sign of sustainable content. What?
Who is Cooper2723?
What a smooth voice.
The fastest growing YouTuber on the platform.
Holy shit.
Any sign of sustainable content. Even while ignoring the fact that all the posts are an average of 3 to 5 minutes or less, this mysterious figure still garners anywhere from 5,000 views all the way to 1 million-plus views. So how does this...
So there's a meme channel.
To find out, we'll dive into YouTube channels and other media surrounding the internet's fastest growing YouTube channel.
Yeah, it's just a meme channel. This doesn't seem that
August
deep.
August 22nd.
Unless there's something crazy. Some kind of crazy revelation.
Online titled, My First Video. What seems like just a random person posting on their first YouTube channel. This video has gathered a sum of 44,000 views. More than the average first video of 90% of YouTubers. Let's watch it together.
Yeah, it's literally just old school YouTuber kind of meme. I mean, smart. Good for them. They found a niche and capitalized. Same dude owns both channels. Ooh, what a conspiracy.
Looking into this video further, it makes it seem mainly like a shitpost. A shitpost is defined as follows. Ironically posting something which to the average person...
Does that have a Merriam-Webster definition now?
Weird or stereotypical post conforming to a norm, but is intended to mock, insult, or amuse.
Thanks, Resub Kintai.
Let's focus on the word amuse. Why would someone on the internet want to post content onto the internet that is seen as shitposting? Furthermore,
this is an interesting
why would
dive.
Someone willingly choose to watch something?
Let's talk about the word amuse. And what is the psychology behind shitposting? What could their goal be? Is it to amuse? But if so, why? And how? A deeper look at the inner machinations of the mind. Here's your mind in an MRI while watching a shitpost. You can see the frontal lobe activity.
Something that is clearly of this nature.
That's like a Vsauce video.
Two YouTubers by the name of Michael P. and Shrick have been seen making content such as this, posting low-quality videos with even more low-quality edits. Michael P. has an astonishing 215,000 subscribers.
Nice, good work, Michael.
His first video being Roblox Inappropriate Place AVI. The account being created on January 12, 2015, which has garnered a staggering 1.3 million views as of the date of recording. What is even more astonishing than that is this was a video uploaded 6 years ago, around the time people started shitposting and when memes were fading into the video scene.
Hey, whoa, whoa, whoa. Let's pump the brakes there, partner. People been shitposting since the first days of the internet. Shitposting is like the oldest tradition of online communities ever. We were built on shitposts. I don't know what he's talking about. It's not new. And it certainly isn't 6 years new. He said in video form. Even then, one of the major first videos online was a shitpost, Dancing Baby. All your base are belong to us. Shitposting's been around since the genesis of the online cyberspace. Newgrounds, yep, Newgrounds was all shitposts. Look at the bits of road talk.
Unfortunately, for Michael P's channel, the last user's upload was in mid-July and has been silent ever since.
Oh,
looking over
it, Michael.
Michael P's entire history on YouTube, in 6 years he has uploaded 119 times, has 215,000 subscribers, and has a total of 25 million views. Moving over to Shrick, this is a creator that has had a more recent account created on August 5th of 2020. With 119 uploads similar to Michael, this creator has 104,000 subscribers and 21 million views. Uploading similar content, this
interesting.
User shockingly close figures to to Michael P. in the span of 2 years compared to 6. You might be wondering why all this information is even important. The growth that Cooper has achieved in a month has outperformed the other two YouTubers by a vast margin, growing at a rate that doesn't seem possible. Now, my first thought was maybe the account was botted. Some person was bored. Bought some subscribers, some comments, and a few
likes. No, I definitely don't think so.
But after going what through seemed infinite videos, I'd realized that these were all real people. Real subscribers, real likes.
Things are prime Chody and Tony.
Genuine people. Now, I want to go back to the word we wanted to focus on, which was amuse. It became evident that people are amused at the posting of Cooper. So much, in fact, that every time he uploads, there are a minimum of a few thousand views within the first few hours.
Okay, so it really just seems like a case of a shitpost channel that got big, as most of them do, but now there's so many more people online, it grew a lot faster than the others. Nothing nefarious, nothing too wild there. Here, let's see, Roblox Escape the School.
Maybe you could go in here. Okay, oh, damn, I found it. Okay.
Yeah, it's just a kid shitposting. And it got big. As a lot of shitposting does. Is it resub surgical? Reminds me of when German did a 2009 live stream. Man, I wonder if all my old live streams, well, they're not, I already looked for them from a while back. But I used to stream in legitimately unwatchable quality. Unregistered Hypercam 2. Mm-hmm, OG. Have the links to your old Justin TV account. Nice. Yeah, unfortunately, there's nothing on there, though. Real Pro streaming 480. What are you talking about? It wasn't 480. It was so much lower than 480. Look at this. Though I do have to wonder if it was this bad on Justin TV or if it's just the re-upload that was this bad. No telling for sure. Thanks a bit, Rotok. I don't really remember that one, Rotok. Could be the capture program. Yeah, that's what I'm wondering. I know the quality was really bad in general, though. I just don't remember it being that bad. So we can do Hobbit runs? Nah, probably not. If I was confident enough in my ability to do the run well, I would, but it would take me legitimately like 45 minutes just to hit the first trick. It's just so fucking hard. Thanks for you, some Milkman in Red. No. I'm still doing Lego Hobbit speedruns right now. I'll do another speedrun game at some point, just not now. I want to get good at this one. Or decent at this one, I suppose. Spent so much time learning the route last night. Thanks to the bits of Rotuck and the gift sub Amber Pin. You consider Grandma's Kisses a shitpost? Probably. I think so. I think it probably fits. You ever gonna speedrun Minecraft? I've tried. That shit is so hard. I don't know how Tfue makes it look so easy. Like, it's always like seed hunting, and even then, it's so tough. Like, you can't misclick even once. Why did this get age restricted? Oh, because of the new YouTube policy. Oh yeah, you guys see that? I'm sure you guys saw this on Twitter. Well, maybe not. YouTube secretly rolled out a new policy that just demonetized, like, everybody. Like, because it retroactively applied to everyone's account. So the new rule fucked a ton of people, myself included, obviously. RT Game got hit, like, the hardest from what I've seen. But it's pretty bad. Can you elaborate? Yeah. The new change is if you say any profanity at all, even like light ones, you know, ass, that kind of thing, within the first 8 to 15 seconds of a video, you get demonetized, no questions asked, no wiggle room. But if you say profanity later on, you are theoretically supposed to be fine. But that's not the case right now. It seems totally random. So like they mention, here, I'll pull it up. They mention in their terms, like their new policy, that the only time you'll lose monetization on a video is if you, for language, is if you say like, fuck, you know, fuck every sentence, or you're like hard profanity in every line, then you lose monetization. But it looks like you can still lose it from even just minorly saying anything bad. Let's see, where can I find the new one? I think they just updated the straight rules here. Let me see. Yeah, they did. Oh, no, they didn't. These still aren't updated here. I'll have to find, like, the official one again, but yeah. So, they've done a big crackdown on any kind of profanity, anything like that. But the biggest one, and what really hit RT Game, I think, is they have cracked down super, super hard on violent video games. So, Callisto Protocol. My Callisto Protocol video is age-restricted. Everyone's Callisto Protocol video is age-restricted because the game is deemed too violent. But that also extends to, like, horror games that are too shocking. I guess shooters that are too gory, perhaps. For me, a video that got demonetized today that was a real head-scratcher is when I made the God Slap 2 announcement. Because I actually don't say any profanity at all. Throughout that entire video, I don't say anything that's not standard polite language until 5 minutes and 38 seconds into the video when I was recapping issue 1. I said fuck. So it couldn't have been a profanity thing because there was only one piece of profanity. But in that God Slap video for issue 2, we had an animation. And that animation had violence. There was blood in the animation, and that happened at a minute 45 seconds. So having blood in the animation must have triggered the full demonetization of it. So it's very, very strict. So overnight, a ton of channels, RT seems to be the most vocal about it, have been hit by a massive wave of demonetized content across the board. And they didn't say shit about this change. They didn't mention it. It demonetizes anything with red paint. Is that confirmed? Does it actually? I wouldn't be surprised. So it's a gore filter? It's an everything filter. profanity, even, so they made it in their terms, they now say all profanity is treated equally except for hell and damn, they point out specifically, aren't going to be treated as profane. And they also said that they're not going to treat censored or bleeped words as profanity, though I highly doubt that. I'm pretty sure they still will count those. So it's an everything filter. Things they give some smiley and the prime tug and the resub bray and Poshy. Why are they making YouTube a kids thing? I don't know, because they're not struggling for ads right now. YouTube's actually doing super well monetarily from everything I've read. So it actually just doesn't make any sense, because all they're doing is losing money on all of that shit now since it's been demonetized. By putting everything in that demonetized bucket, they no longer can put the ads on it themselves either. So they're literally just cutting off a source of their income. A big source from a ton of channels. I don't get it. They must have gotten threatened. I just don't know. I don't know if I even believe that. Like, I don't see who would threaten them. I think it's the resub unreal. Tristan Tate released and no trafficking charges. It was rumors. Here, let me refresh. Let's see if that's confirmed. Right now, the only source is Rap TV, which apparently is not a reliable source. All reputable sources here are still reporting it as human trafficking, so independent, I believe BBC as well, that hasn't changed yet, so I'm gonna wait for like a more reputable source that's not just Twitter-centric. Because even in the official broadcast, the word trafficking was on screen, it seemed. So we'll see. But yeah, that'd be huge. That would be huge. He's a prime Garkane. And he's the resub bub. Have you heard of Car Jutsu before? Of course I have. Did you see the police chase on ABC7? Yeah, we already saw that. It wasn't too wild. Check Aiden's reaction to Tate's arrest. Are you talking about his tweet? God, yeah, that was kind of rough. I will never understand the shamelessness to publicly beg and whine on Twitter. I guess whining I get, but begging. That's just never a good look for anyone. Think the resub tactics. He made a whole video on it. Oh no. Thanks to the gift sub salute. Thanks to the 5 gift subs, bunny. Thanks to the Prime Purple Pain. When did the internet peak? I think we're hitting the internet peak. I find the internet to be in, like, the most fun state it's been in such a long time. Like, just the constant source of, like, outrageous clownery across the entire landscape. I don't know how you don't like that. Unlimited access to the goofiest shit imaginable. Every day I can go on Twitter and see a new Waffle House fight. Like, we're definitely in peaking internet. I know everyone loves the golden age of YouTube or whatever, where it was like Fred that dominated and shit because they've cherry-picked their favorite moments as kids. But the internet back then wasn't that great. I love the more Wild West nature of it back then, where there was more variety, where it wasn't just a conglomerate of like three websites everyone goes to. But aside from that, the content itself wasn't better. But I did appreciate the variety. You think it's getting repetitive sometimes? Oh, absolutely. Some of it's really artificial, like drama that's fucking worthless and not entertaining. Yeah, absolutely. But then pretty much every day you're gonna find something goofy and something fun. Exit tier one. Sintrize and the Resub Ectobius and Prime Christian. And the Prime Nocturnal. Corporations taking over kind of sucks. I don't know if corporations are necessarily taking over when it comes to content, but they keep getting pushed really hard by like YouTube and shit. So yeah, that is frustrating. I don't like that. But they're not like killing it with content or anything. Do you like censorship? No, that's why I just said I liked the anything goes nature back in the day a bit more, but as far as content and all that goes, I think it's in its best state. Because there's just so much of it, there's always something. I also don't think the censorship is... I mean, it's definitely more prevalent now. But even back in the day, it existed too. Early internet, I remember, like, Maddox had a huge site back in the day. But I remember after like a ton of repeated like character assassination attacks on it, like it became increasingly hard to find that site mysteriously. Like the censorship still existed even back during the golden age of the internet too. So it's just always been there, unfortunately. But yeah, I hate it. Not to this extent. Yeah, probably not to this extent. But I'm just saying it's nothing new. It's just becoming more prevalent, which does suck. I completely agree. And yeah, I have seen that one, Bricks. Feel like you can't say shit that goes against the general thinking because if someone gets offended and he's part of the subcategory, you can get canceled even though you were just expressing a point. I just completely disagree. In fact, one of the most lucrative things you can do right now is go against the grain. Shit, I mean, like, let's just use Andrew Tate as an example. When you go against the grain, people flock to you and they love to spend money on that. Even if you don't even believe the shit you're talking about, just like grifting it, you can make a ton of money going against the grain. It's a huge thing. Now, of course, there's a line you have to walk. You have to be careful not to go, like, too hard into the show. But yeah, like, you going against the grain is probably, like, the most lucrative thing you can do right now. You make more money going with the grain? Maybe. It's hard to say. to give an example, going against the grain. So I think it's pretty clear most of like the general internet is like more left leaning. But if you look at things from the right side, you make so much money there. Good example. Do you guys remember 3 years ago, I think it was, a guy released a book called 100 Reasons Why to Vote Democrat? And that book sold over $100,000 worth for him overnight, and it was just a book of empty pages. Like, people spend tons and tons and tons of money for anyone that goes against the grain. No matter what you're doing, as long as you are going against the grain, you find a huge audience, and you make a ton of money from it. Even if you don't believe it. So I just disagree. I don't think going against the grain is like a death sentence or anything. It's actually a really, like, common and big thing to do. Alex Jones, yeah. His empire is worth, what, $800 million or something? Yeah. That's the joke. Oh, I know, and it's a goofy gag joke, but it's certainly not worth hundreds of thousands of dollars. That's what I'm saying. Like, it's a low effort, nothing, easy to do, easy thing. And you can do that repeatedly. So you can just 100% go against the grain. It's not a death sentence, man. I've said this before, I'll say it a million times. No matter who you are, no matter what you do, what you say, you will always, always find an audience online eventually. Like, there's a whole lot of luck to it, but no matter what, people will agree with you. You will always find people to agree. People just, like, naturally want to be part of these, like, tribes. So no matter what, you're going to find people that will support you. Like that artist that does shit art but sells for millions. Well, Damien Hirst, it's money laundering. A little different, but yeah. And the bits, Tori, they're some valid. Thanks, Recep J. EDP still has fans. EDP is an open pedophile and still has a massive following. Exactly. You will always have people that will follow and support no matter what. If anyone gained an audience, why isn't anyone buying my butthole pics? You gotta market yourself better. Take some notes from the OnlyFans girls. I think you're exaggerating a bit. I think you're exaggerating a lot. Although you're right to an extent about going against the grain. Man, why am I having so much trouble reading that? Very small text for some reason. Going against the grain will gain some amount of attention since it's controversial and drama attacks people, but general masses will be very much against you. And even the people who succeed going against the grain, very few, most people who voice their opinions that are controversial get the Tate treatment. I think there was like a lot of thoughts in there, and I'm a little confused, but I think your overall point is, yeah, you might be able to get like an audience and money from it, but people won't like you. But no matter what, people are not going to like you. I think most people have realized that by now. The internet's connected everyone. I think everyone now knows there's always going to be people that don't like you, no matter what. So I don't think that's a bother to anyone anymore. Like, if you can make a living by just being controversial, I feel like most people just take it. There's no reason not to. Even if you try and make a living not being controversial, you're still going to have people hate you. Thanks, Erisa. Hamoud and Cheese and Jay. $150K versus 3 mil, it's not a comparison. I don't even know what you're talking about. Is that against my point or for it? I can't tell. Because, like, again, this is just such a good example. Like, Andrew Tate. He has 3.2 million followers on Twitter and has made millions and millions and millions and millions of dollars by selling $50 Discord servers. Now, I get that he's an exception, not necessarily the rule. But, like, that trickles down. There's, like, a ton of people in that community. There's a ton of people that make a living doing similar things. Just going against the grain. Things the Prime Cloud and the resub Hera. Yeah, you can find examples from both sides though. That's my point. No one side is like doing better than the other, like based on like a against the grain, with the grain. Like they both succeed equally in their own verticals. Like I don't know what you mean. My point is, by being controversial or going against the grain, it's not a death sentence. You still do well. You have like the same capacity to do well as the people who go with the grain. That's the whole point I'm making. Thanks to Prime, Carl. The resub noob. Do you think crypto will ever be regulated or will it be a scam forever? I have no fucking idea, man. I don't think so. In regards to it being a scam forever, I think at some point that whole blockchain shit might actually be utilized for something good. I've said that for a long time. I think there's potential with it, but it's only scams right now. But only right now. I really do feel like there is something good that can offer. But it won't be in the form of like crypto coins and shit, I don't think. AI will control it. Yeah, maybe. Way less likely to make a living off social media if you're against the grain. I guess we're just going to disagree. I think you have the same capacity to succeed. There, again, are so many examples from both sides of people that have made a very successful career just being as squeaky clean as possible and as, you know, non-offensive as possible. And there have been people that have been extremely successful being as offensive as possible and far from clean. Like, it's just, I really think it's the same capacity on both sides. Now, of course, the people that go against the grain do get more public backlash, but everyone gets public backlash. There's nothing that's inoffensive. Like, in general, there's just nothing that's fully inoffensive. People are going to not like some things. Always. You're just always going to have people that don't like you. So even if they do get more shit publicly, they're still just as fine as the other people that are doing the normal, like, with the grain activities. Puppies are inoffensive. You haven't been on Twitter, have you? I watched a fucking video. What was it? Must have been yesterday. Of someone just playing with a dog and the dog being super cute. One of the top fucking comments was one of those goddamn armchair veterinarians. I was like, I can't believe what I'm watching right now. She's torturing this dog. Oh, cat. It was a cat. Now, I'm getting so many things mixed up. I watch a lot of the cute animal videos that float around. The one that had the outrageous comments is the cat. There was a cat that got super excited anytime the automated feeder went off. So they'd be playing with the cat and then the automated feeder goes off and the cat goes after it and it's really cute. It's so cute. All of the comments, I'm exaggerating, a ton of the comments, top comments, tons of likes, were about how this cat must be starved to get excited for the food. This cat has to be malnourished and abused in order to get this excited for food. This is clearly a case of the cat associating the feeder with anxiety and stress because it might not know when the next meal comes. everything is a problem online, no matter what. No matter what you think is safe, there's always going to be people that take an issue with it. Let's not forget teabagging. Oh, teabagging in a video game. Like, again, there will always be an issue for some people with everything in general. So for the other side, like if you're going against the grain, you're going to get backlash anyway. Yes, you get more going against the grain, but does it really matter when you're still successful? For most people, the answer is no. To tie the whole point back together. Thanks to the Bits KT and Camus. No such thing as bad publicity. I completely agree with that now. The only time there's a such thing as bad publicity is when it's a crime or you are a business that relies on goodwill for sales. Great example, Artesian Builds. God rest its soul. CEO makes an absolute fucking bumbling fool out of himself on live stream, sinks the company overnight. Those are the only two times there's a such thing as bad publicity, though. Oh, Panda Global. Another great example. You're more likely to be canceled going against the grain. Not wrong. Again, you're not wrong. But I also think canceling isn't exactly what a lot of people think it is. Getting shit on Twitter doesn't matter to a lot of people because it's just Twitter. Like, they're still fine and move on just fine if they put their head down and keep doing what they've been doing. But even then, even when you go against the grain, you have a very real risk of being canceled too for anything, really. Mr. Beast gets cancellation attempts constantly because they view some of the things he does as, exploiting people for views, even though, like, he does a lot for charity and shit, or, like, Team Trees not actually being useful, it's all performative. Like, no matter what you do, there will always be a cancellation attempt and shit. Doesn't matter if you're going with or against the grain. Mr. Beast, and he's too big to fail. And it's not even a matter of being too big to fail. Again, even people that are more controversial that get canceled on Twitter move on just fine. Take a shot every time grain is said. Yeah, true. Thanks, Resub John and Jeff. I was thinking about that, Camus. It could be fun. Don't know if I'll do it, though. Oh, man. That felt good. Thanks. Oh, you said that. Oh, goddamn. Thank you for the 20 gift subs, one dose of dope. God, thank you for the fat drop, man. Thanks for you, Brandon. Hope you had a good day. Thank you for the generosity. Jesus. You remember when people thought peanut butter and jelly sandwiches were racist? I don't remember that, but I remember when 4chan convinced the world... Well, not the world... convinced the media that the okay hand gesture was actually racist and a white power symbol. I remember that. I think that still exists too. I think the media still believes that. Is it Resub Brendan and Bar Loopy? It's actually a thing now after all that. I couldn't tell you if it's a thing now, but it certainly wasn't at the beginning. It was a legitimate 4chan joke that they actually picked up and ran with. So maybe now it actually became a thing. I have no idea. But it was a 4chan joke. And they ran with it. Fucking wild. I also remember 4chan tried a really wacky one that I genuinely thought was going to work. They had a jump for Trump. They were trying to... I think this was right after they convinced the media the okay hand gesture was white power. They tried to do a jump for Trump trend where it was supposed to be about like protesting Trump. Libs are now throwing themselves from rooftops or something. They tried to give tried to get a lot of steam behind that, but I think it only got picked up by one or two outlets. Like 4chan actually controls so much of the media narrative now, it seems. It's wild. Okay, controls is the wrong word. Influences so much of the media coverage and overall narrative. Chan dead in the water now that had power in 2016. They're dwindling a little bit, but I still think 4chan is still very huge. And I think it always will be. It's just kind of spread out a little more on 4chan. It's no longer just B-board or anything like that. Thanks to the bits, peanut. Yes, I actually did watch that, Peanut. That was a very interesting case. The New York Times and PBS have articles about peanut butter and jelly sandwiches being racist. I've got to look that up. That sounds unreal. Peanut butter, jelly, and racism. Oh my. This is from 2016. I didn't even know about this one. Where is it? Oh, do you have to pay for the New York Times? Oh, wait. I will never do that. Implicit bias. Peanut butter, jelly, and racism. This is from PBS, but this is a video. I'll watch the video. Fuck it. Let me see.
Implicit bias.
2016 was the year that implicit bias went somewhat mainstream.
Yeah, so when Hillary Clinton mentioned implicit bias...
What does this have to do with peanut butter and jelly?
Our phones started blowing up, all our friends started emailing us about it.
But what is implicit bias? Implicit biases are basically thought processes that happen without you even knowing it.
Little cool background music.
Judgments you might not agree with. And sometimes the shortcuts are based on race. First, some clarity. Saying someone has an implicit bias is different from calling someone a racist.
The word racist is a highly...
So this was a 4chan thing?
Here in American society.
That they ran with?
A lot of times when people are using it, they're thinking of the kind of old-fashioned Ku Klux Klan style racist.
But implicit bias isn't anywhere near that, you know, explicit.
Implicit bias is something that comes out of ordinary mental functioning, out of
how
the mind normally works.
So what?
We've
what
all
the fuck
grown
is this?
Up whole life. We never even, because through, I'm gonna say jelly. That's an association that's been ingrained in me because throughout my life, peanut butter and jelly are together. And in many forms of media, there is an overrepresentation of Black men and violent crime being paired together.
They're using peanut butter and jelly to make a point. They're not calling peanut butter and jelly racist, at least not the impression I get. They're just using it as a metaphor. You sure that was it? Uh, Because that is that's not them calling peanut butter and jelly racist. There was rumors that schools banned PB&J because of racism. I don't know about all that, but that video, and I'm guessing the New York Times one by extension, since it's the same title, is not calling peanut butter and jelly racist. Here's a prime, Riz. Let's talk about the reptilian elite. Oh. Reptilian shit's always so fascinating. Thanks to Resub Storm and ZD and Sentinel and Colt and Sovereign. Do you remember the article from 2017 that said Paw Patrol was fascist? Yeah, I did make a video on that, didn't I? That shit was real. They legitimately tried to make arguments for why Paw Patrol was fascism. It was cool. That shit went so hard. Thanks to the resub Luca and Keyblade. Reptilian theory invented based on racist writings of Madame Blavatsky. I don't know about all that, man, but reptilian shit is so fascinatingly goofy. I still love the reptilians caught mid-morph. I will always love these. This isn't a compilation, but let's see this one.
We are following today's events in Egypt very closely. And we'll have more to say as this plays out.
Resub up in Pyro.
But what is absolutely clear is that we are witnessing history unfold. It's a moment of transformation that's taking place because the people
of
Egypt are calling for change. And they've turned out in extraordinary numbers.
Replayed.
Now, as we watch what's taking place, we're also reminded that we live in an interconnected world.
Where's the morph?
What happens across the globe has an...
I didn't see it. I'm just going to go to a compilation. Where's the compilations at? Oh my god, I just realized that video was just from CNN. It wasn't even a reptilian channel. It was just a clip of Obama talking about transformation instead of a reptilian transformation. Did YouTube purge all the reptilian content? What happened to it? I thought reptilian morphs were still on YouTube, like the reptilians caught on tape and shit, but I guess not. That's one of the main reasons I used to watch Rumble. Before it became what it currently is. Now I don't go on it, like, at all. But I used to go on Rumble because most of the conspiracy theorists that believed in, like, flat Earth, hollow Earth, fake moon, reptilians, all of them went to Rumble, so I used to watch them. But I still thought some of it existed here, but I guess not. They really purged all the conspiracies. Huh. These are some Mario Boyman and Odyssey. If you see context, it's GG. Yeah. That's unfortunate. Fuck, that's sad. Those were great. Sort by new. Don't think that would change anything. Plus, it's not what I'm looking for either. Those are never that good. Type shape-shifting. Won't change it. Looks like they just got rid of all of it. This one's clearly a joke about it. Yeah. I wish you could at least sort it by, like, controversial. Man, fucking purged all the reptilian content. Fuck me. Might be easy to find on TikTok. Yeah, probably. But I'm not pulling TikTok up on stream. Try lizard people. I've watched all of these compilations. They always use reptilian, but let's see. Nope. I wonder, is my video the last one showcasing the reptilian transformations? Because I made a video on it, like, earlier this year. Oh, I guess it was last year, yeah. Reptilians finally caught. But even when you type that in for me, it comes up with a warning about reptilians. But at least mine's still here. Show us, it's this one. This is one of their morphing episodes. I'm so sad they got rid of that. I actually was still under the impression it was here. Fucking shame. Search by top, I see some there. Relevant is suppressed. I feel like that's dangerous. I've never sorted by view count. Oh, wait, you're right.
Hi, guys. This is something I just spotted on the Spanish news. Possible proof of reptilians living among us. So I was just watching TV.
Yeah, you're going to see some crazy shit now.
To have a shower, come back and watch it. And I'm looking at this reporter, and I notice something about his eyes at the very last minute. Just when he thinks that the broadcast...
Yeah, it's about to morph.
We spot something in his eyes. And this is really shocking. I was shocked. I was so happy I taped it, because it can go back and...
Things are tier one casual.
But he blinks, and he has a second set of eyes. I'm about to see this. Just at the very end. Coming up now, we're going to see.
Oh god, he's going to. I can see it. I can already see those eyes poking through.
Do you see that? Second set of eyes.
Well, you can't argue with that. Fuck me. I told you they're here. I've been warning you. Whew. Can't argue with that. What do the comments say again? Oh, they're just trying to, like... Like, disprove it. You can't. Try as you will, it's... useless in the face of... tangible proof of the lizard people. Don't know if I'm gonna be able to sleep now. Yeah, you better not. And you better not be sleeping on your stomach with the reptilians out there. They'll come and fucking get you right in your butt. That's how they come in. That's how they take you over. The lizard people do not play games. Not on this rock. Have you seen the Sleeping Stone Giants / Mountains? Sounds familiar. I don't know, though. Maybe. I'll put a big maybe on that one. Oh, wait. Is this the video we watched? Long time ago? No, maybe not. Why is Danielle Bregoli here? Did she have a morph? Oh, here's one.
The most controversial conspiracy theory. Some believe that reptilians have infiltrated the world's governments.
Mm-hmm.
So, from a reptilian head to a full transformation, join us. A popular Islamic preacher, Yusuf Estes, is the founder and host of Guide TV. Interestingly, during one of his services, Yusuf's head briefly transformed into a reptilian-looking creature.
His cloaking device malfunctioned.
I don't do it through debates. I don't need to debate any Christian. I was a Christian. I am a Muslim. If you want, I can give you both sides. Easy. But he will ask you if you deliver the
message.
I'll play both parts. I'll be the Christian and tell you this, and then I'll be the
His
Muslim
disguise glitched. Twice. Let me see you for what you really are.
Then I'll be the Muslim and give the answer.
Jesus Christ. Madness. Absolute madness. And they thought we wouldn't notice. That's the most insulting part. They think we're so dumb we don't see him transform.
The temple of that religion. And the father was the priest there. What would you think?
Caught red-handed. Now that one's pretty cut and dry. Into a Komodo dragon, even. Exit Prime Rex.
As previously mentioned, most alleged reptilians are identified by facial transformations, including notably the eyes. In one video, taken from the BBC program Antiques Roadshow, an unidentified person oddly stares
Whoa!
At the camera. Further, his eyes appear far larger than normal.
Fuck me. He is looking very intensely at the camera, though. That guy might legitimately be a reptilian. I'm starting to be convinced the more I look at him, honestly. Thanks to the resub, Death in Sesho.
Another transformation revolves around the tongue. In 1995, NBC News reporter Isaiah Carey.
He has glasses on? Swallowed a- Who paid you to say that? I don't see no glasses. That sounds like a load of baloney. There's only one explanation for that. Lizard.
The action were merely a distraction away from the tongue. Bizarrely, it appears to be too large, an odd color, and generally distorted.
What really happened on that Thursday here at Augusta High School that led to Chris Wood's death?
This is a classic video, actually. I like how even in his, like, proof of reptilian, you can actually just watch that bug fly into his mouth. It doesn't come from his mouth. That's so wild. But no, it's a reptilian tongue. Clearly. I mean, just look at the slowed down footage.
Whilst the majority of reptilian videos only show a minor malfunction, a few actually contain a full transformation. In this controversial CCTV video, an unknown person walks towards an alley, stops, and is replaced by a larger shadow, whilst the original body remains in place.
What? Have we seen this one? This isn't ringing any bells right now. Where is that reptilian? Oh, I see. He spit him out, like shedding his skin. He's over here now. Yeah, I mean, there was nothing to see. It's just like a shadow.
In a similar doubtful but intriguing video, filmed last September in Mexico, a shapeshifter appears to take the form of their boyfriend.
So has the shapeshifter already done it? Is he now the boy? Oh my god. Imagine they just trample him. This is... What the fuck is happening? Ruined Avatar Way of Water. Lizard person confirmed. It was clearly a shape-shifting reptilian. Yeah, I actually do remember that goblin. Yeah, I love that reptilian shit. Hold on, let me fill up my water real quick. I'll be right back.